Talking about, you know, honoring this city's firefighters. They put their lives on the line for us. And the members of the fire brigade here in Jacksonville are going to march through the streets of downtown today to honor those who've made the ultimate sacrifice.
Yeah, coming up in about an hour and a half or so, the Sea of Blue. Here's Ashley Harding with more.
The public is encouraged to line the route and also to wear red. Now, the route this morning includes Ashley, Duval, and Liberty Streets and ends here at Fire Station 1. And you can see the Jacksonville Fireman's Memorial Wall. The names of all 22 fallen Jacksonville firefighters are engraved. And if you look over this way, you can see where the firefighters have set up the risers in preparation for this morning's tribute.
The annual Sea of Blue March through downtown Jacksonville is a moving tribute to our fallen firefighters. This is News for Jack's footage from last year's event. Following the march, each hero's name is read aloud in a special program at Fire Station 1. This week, firefighters worked to get the grounds ready for today's event. The wall nearby is a solemn reminder of the sacrifice these heroes made in our community and how easily this can happen again. I spoke on the phone with Randy Wise, president of the Jacksonville Association of Firefighters.
Every time those firefighters get on those trucks, there's a risk that they may end up on that wall.
In all, 22 firefighters have been killed in the line of duty, the first death happening more than 130 years ago. Wise knows several of the firefighters whose names are engraved on the wall, including 22-year-old Carl Cliff Kramer, who died from heat stroke in 2005.
Those the names are mean to those people personally, and that's why it's so important to us on this day to show the respect.
This year's route begins on South Hogan Street before moving to Duval Street in front of City Hall. From there, it'll turn north onto Laura for two blocks, and then participants will march east on Ashley Street until reaching Fire Station 1 on Liberty. The public is encouraged to come and watch this moving tribute.
And the march begins at 10 o'clock this morning. It's expected to last about 45 minutes with the program beginning promptly at 11 o'clock. We've posted the entire route on newsforjax.com as well as a little more information about each of the 22 fallen firefighters. I'm Ashley Harding, Channel 4, the local station.